In this video, we are going to take a look at eCADSTAR's schematic interface and the humble connection, the net, the connectivity between your devices. How easy is this and what options do we have? And we are focusing on just the drawing options available to us in eCADSTAR, not any preloading of PCB geometry requirements like trace width, net-to-net clearance, shielding, layer restrictions, or even color. Simply the drawing options. Okay, so connections, pretty simple. In the first instance, we have coincident connections. Drop a device pin onto another pin and it makes a connection for us as we drag away. The next method, regardless of whichever mode you happen to be in the schematic, is if you simply drag away from a symbol pin, it will launch the net mode for you and add a net. As you can see from this dialog, we have three options for net entry. Actually four if we include through connections, and a fifth if we include coincident pin placement. I use the manual connection method in this second net connection, where every direction change needs input from the user. Let me undo that and repeat it before we look at the others. Semi-automatic. We click on the start point and we click on the end point. The net is then left floating on our cursor for us to position. I find myself using this one the most. Then we have automatic. Click on a start point, click on an end point, and eCADSTAR will determine where the net should go. It does a pretty good job. The automatic net connections did a nice job for us because the devices were on a uniform staggered matrix and it looks at the center distance as the starting point. But if we align these devices on one edge, we can still use the auto connect. It will connect A to B for us. We may well see some overlaps depending on device placement, but we can simply move the devices and it will snap the nets to the next working grid and align them neatly for us. With through connection enabled, we can simply draw our net straight through devices and eCADSTAR breaks the net up into system generated net names for us. Okay, let's look at some of the other connectivity options: copy and paste, bus connections, inter and intra sheet connections, and global signals. Here I'm using the manual connection method because I only have one pin to connect to, and I'm just going to enter a few of these and copy them down. Let's ignore the pin functions being displayed on this device and imagine we have a nice, uncomplicated data bus. You will see if I undo those connections that I can also preload these nets with net names and set it to auto increment as we move on to the next one. Better yet would be to enter this as a proper bus. We have a few different ways we can manage the names of the nets and the bus, so let's start with the increment net bus feature. Once the nets are entered, we can auto-increment the names. Depending on the direction I drive my cursor, it will name the nets accordingly. So, top to bottom, or bottom to top. Next, I can use the name net bus feature, and this is a really, really neat feature. I'll expand on this in a moment, but you can see here, if I click on a segment of the bus, eCADSTAR knows which nets are physically connected to the bus. I can then use this feature to preload the bus name for me, concatenating the data series into a bus name. We can override that as well if we want. Let's backpedal a little and I can show you that feature being used on individual nets. I'm going to bring in the second gate for this device and connect a few pins up to a global signal. Now this global signal has no predefined net name, it is net neutral, but I can use the same naming method as before. So eCADSTAR looks at all the connected pin names and offers them as suggestions for net names. Again, we are not obliged to use them, we can override them. We're now free to copy this device to use in other places and it will retain that net name. We can of course change this from the properties dialog, or once connected to some nets, we can use the same net name bus command we've just been using. I haven't shown you inter and intra sheet connectors, but they can be named in exactly the same way as this global signal and they are hyperlinked, so you can click on them and they will take you to the corresponding sheet where the net with the same net name exists. As you can see, eCADSTAR is offering us some really easy to use connection methods and lots of options and flexibility regarding net names.